Hello there. Thank you very much for coming along. Quite a few people. I'm a bit disappointed with that. But anyway, my talk would be on automated web acceptance testing using Behat and how can you use Behat for automating your acceptance tests right from the sprint planning. My name is Shashikant. My Twitter is Shashikant86. I work for a company called iBuildings. iBuildings is a PHP specialized company, basically. They provide the PHP services to various e-commerce clients all across UK and Europe. Basically, Behat is a BDD tool for PHP. We might be seeing a lot of PHP tool, BDD tools for the Ruby applications, .NET applications, or maybe Java applications. But the Behat is the first ever BDD tool for the PHP applications. And so this comes with another tool called Menk, which is a web acceptance framework for the BDD tools. In this presentation, we're gonna talk about some bits and pieces about the Behat, the Menk, and Behat integrated with the Source Labs, and how we can use the Relish for our living documentation stuff. Then we'll talk about how can you integrate the Behat features on the continuous integration tools like Jenkins. And then we'll see some useful links about using Behat in your projects. Basically, Behat is developed by in a France company called KNP Labs, developed by the Constantin. So he is famous on the Twitter as Everzet. It's a BDD approach. A lot of people talk about the BDD approach, how you can do BDD in your projects. Since the Dan North coined the term BDD, so a lot of people comes with the stories and definitions of the Gherkin, how you can write the Gherkin, start from the sprint planning, and then automate your acceptance tests right from the scratch. That worked well for the Ruby applications using Cucumber, and we can automate our functional tests using Cucumber and Selenium or Cucumber or Capybara libraries. And yeah, so the functional testing can be achieved by using Cucumber. The Behat works in the same way like Cucumber. That uses basically different Menk drivers called Selenium web driver or Sahi or some other driver. So it comes with different drivers. Some headless drivers are there. In terms of the domain specific language that use Gherkin, so basically Gherkin is a language which is defined by the Matvine and is written in a given when then format. The Gherkin is understood by BDD tools, and BDD tools can generate the well-defined code for you, well-defined codes and method for you to implement your step definitions. And coming to Menk, Menk is a web acceptance test framework for the PHP applications. And it comes with different headless as well as the browser controller drivers. So it has, as I said earlier, it supports Selenium 1 and WebDriver. So it has different APIs like a browser controller as well as the APIs that we can use for automating every browser actions that users do on a user can perform on a browser, basically. The basic browser interactions like Selenium has is like Selenium has open, the Menk has visit, Selenium has get location, Menk has get current URL and stuff. So here's a list of the browser interaction that user can do on using Menk. So it's basically all the browser interactions that user can do is can be found on Menk APIs. There are plenty of Menk APIs that can be used. in terms of automating the applications. In terms of Behat installation, assuming that you have already got the Behat package installed, then you can run some basic commands like installing the Behat Symfony package and Gherkin and Behat. So there's a bunch of commands as mentioned there. So if you run this command, you will get Behat installed. The same way Mink installation is fairly simple. You just need to upgrade the channels and install Mink right there. Once you run all this command, you can check your installation by running Behat version. So you can get if you see the correct version of the Behat right there, then you will successfully install the Behat. Then Mink. Once Mink is installed, then you can use Mink directly on your PHP classes by including this require mink/autoload.php file into your PHP classes. There are different ways of installation. You can use it using GitHub, or you can use it using a far file for installation. You need to include the Mink autoload file or Mink far file into your PHP classes. It's a start for your project. First of all, you need to make a new directory for your Behat project. And once you install everything, you have to navigate to that directory using command cd to that particular project. Then if you run this command behat init, then you will see something like this, place your feature file here or something like that. So that message pops up when you initialize the project. Then when we initialize the behat, then it will automatically create the features directory for you. And the feature directory contains the bootstrap directory as well as the feature context class. So the automatically generated feature context.php file looks like this, basically. Is it not readable, but it looks like this. It has some basic constructor well-defined and some basic methods like how we can implement the step definitions using that. So this is often a step. You can define some bootstrap.php file if you wish to use all your Mink and all this stuff, PHP, Selenium dependencies. You can put it in here and set time zone and stuff. This is often a step. You can include whatever the stuff that you find useful in your application, so that it can be run before you run every test. Then this is the basic configuration that you need to do to use the Behat. This is the basic configuration file that has defined. This is a YAML file and it defines all the parameters that has been used by Mink and browser emulation. So the parameter mentioned here is one of the parameter mentioned here is a JavaScript session. So the JavaScript session is basically the drivers, Mink drivers that you can use it in for the browser emulation. Basically, you can use Selenium, you can use WebDriver, or you can use SourceLab stuff. That's the basic idea about the configuration, base configuration you can use for. This is very simple configuration. You can extend it further. When we're done with all this configuration, then next step would be the writing the feature files. The feature file should be like for every story in your project. That should looks like three lines of the feature, and then you design the scenarios underneath that. Say for example, your story is like doing wiki search. Then you will define the feature like, in order to search information on wiki as a wiki user, I want to get sensible result from the site. Once you then define this feature file, then you can define the scenarios like search keyword on wiki or whatever scenario in given when then format. So you can do it right from the scratch, like if you got to understand the feature, then you can define the scenario accordingly. And in this example, there's fairly simple getting files, which is showing the given I'm on this page, and I fill the search box with input. When I press search button, then I should see the output. So here is the basically data-driven test, which has the examples in it, like what you put in there. Like when I fill search box with input, then it will take values from this input, like there's London, Beijing, Mumbai. So these values are taken, and the test run 3 times. Then in terms of output, then I should see the output. The output should be like the things that in written in their local languages. So that should appear on the page. So once you go to the project and again run the Behat command, then you will get the list of methods and undefined methods, and the method has been populated for you, though you can just copy these methods and implement it in your feature context file. So these are the methods, you can just copy it and use the Mink API for implementing all these step definitions. Here you can go back to your feature context file for implementing your step definitions. So the idea is like, we got the, in this feature, we got the method called, I fill in the search box with argument 1, then you can implement, you can copy that, I fill in search box with input, then you can use the Mink APIs like fill-filled, or there are a huge bunch of Mink API. As per your application requirement, you can use any Mink APIs for automating that stuff. Then again, another method we got in here is I press the button. So this button, pressing the button, you can implement it by using click method. So you can get the Mink API with this code, like you can write get main, get session, get driver, and click there, then wait for some time maybe. You can add JavaScript condition if you want to wait for specific JavaScript condition to be true or be false. So okay, once you implemented all your method step definitions, then you need to start your engines, like start your Selenium server basically. So you can download your Selenium server from this Selenium HQ site and run the jar file too. Well, once you done with your step definitions, all the you launched your engine, Selenium, or whichever your driver you're using. If you're using Selenium 2, then you need to download the jar file, which is Selenium 2.0 or something like that, whichever latest one. After that, when you use Behat command, then you can see the test running in a browser. And once you start your test, this browser launch, search for the different parameter we passed in the test, like first of all, test run for London, then for Beijing, and then for in Dubai. And once it finished it's running, then you can watch the test result. For the test result would be basically looks like this. Well, you can plug your Behat tests, Behat features into on Source Labs. Basically, Source Labs is a cloud testing framework. You can run your tests in the cloud, and there are two. There are basically on-demand services which run automated tests, and Scout services which you can do some manual testing on the on your application, basically. If you wish to run your tests on Source Labs, you need to update your configuration again. Then you need to create another file called source.yml. Then this is the similar looking file that you used in a behat.yml file. And the configuration is almost same, but you need to pass another parameter called browser over there. Then you need to specify your username and API key, and the name of browser, browser version, Windows, OS, and the name of your test. So that's the basic configuration that you can use for running your tests on Source Labs. If you wish to run your configuration or all your test features on the Source Labs, then you need to run command behat and specify the configuration file called /c source.yml. And when you start this test, you will see the test running on the Source Labs, and you can watch the videos over there. And the same result we can get in a local browser. We can see the videos and screenshot of each step, so right over there. So if you wish to see the video of this particular test, you can navigate to this URL and you can watch the whole videos over there. Well, there's another step for the living documentation is a Relish. Relish is application which can maintain your Gherkin files online. So if you wish to use that services, that will store all your Gherkin files online, so that it can be visible for the everyone, and everyone can read your Gherkin feature and contribute to them. Maybe add some new scenarios in it. So that's a really cool tool for maintaining your online living documentation online. So basically, how do you install the Relish? Relish is like you need to have Ruby installed on your computer. Then you just need to run the command called gem install relish, and once you've done that, you go to the UI of the Relish and create a new project. You can do it from command line as well. Define your Relish project and your project name. So if you add your project, the project directory is created will be created on Relish. If you wish to use the private services to secure your application commands and all the features, then you can get the private account for that. There are some pricing plans for this, but you will get the secure your features and all this tests and living documentation, so that it cannot be accessed publicly. Once you define the feature files, you just need to navigate to your features directory and run the relish push command, and then you need to specify the name of project. So all your files has been sent to that particular relish project. So it looks like this basically, this relish application. And once you push your feature onto the relish, then it looks like this basically. It has all our feature file scenario and whatever we written in a Gherkin. So you can see all the stuff over here. Okay, so if you need to try all this Behat and basic stuff, that you can just find the source code on GitHub. The GitHub repository is the link there, and you just clone the repository, then navigate to that repository. If you wish to use the source YAML, just you need to plug your API keys and username to run your tests on source. And if you run aunt command, run source, then you can see all your build is running on the Source Labs, and you can see the reports generated in a HTML file. Once you got all your setup in your machine, then your directory structure looks like this. So you got the feature file, you got the bootstrap file and feature context file, which is auto generated by the Behat. Then you can define your bootstrap.php file, which has all your basic configuration that needs to be run before running your test. Then another thing you got in here is your feature file basically, which is written in Gherkin. Then you can generate reports. The reports are in HTML format, so you can generate it right there. The configuration file we just talked about is behat.yml and source.yml. So behat.yml is basically for running your tests locally, and the source.yml is basically for running your tests on source labs. Now we got another file called build.xml. The build.xml file is basically the on build file. You can set up your targets to schedule your build and run the build on the continuous integration servers like Jenkins or stuff. So let's switch about the running your features on the Jenkins. So basically, Jenkins is most of you know that Jenkins is a continuous integration server, and you can plug all your on task, your maven task, and all of the tasks, even your shell task or something like that, you can plug it on in a Jenkins. And basically you can download the Jenkins. Jenkins is basically WAR file, and you run java jar jenkins.war file that will launch the Jenkins server for you. Once you downloaded the Jenkins, and if you visit the URL of your localhost machine, HTTP localhost and port 8080, basically the Jenkins default, Jenkins use default port 8080, but if you wish to specify a different port, then you can specify a different port to see the Jenkins dashboard. If you wish to configure the new job on your Jenkins instance, then create a new job called Behat source. Then specify the GitHub repository that, as I mentioned earlier, and so the basic configuration will look like this. The Jenkins dashboard, create a new job, then specify the Behat source as your project name or whatever your project name. Then specify the GitHub repository as mentioned there. Then if you scroll down a bit, then you can specify the target of the build XML file. Here we got run source target, and you can publish your report in HTML format by specifying your report structure and the report file name. So the report title I given is source report. So you can keep your parsed HTML report in your Jenkins instance or Jenkins builds to look at what went wrong. If something went wrong, you can just investigate the root cause of the problem. Once you do that, if you build the project, then Jenkins will run the feature files that you define over there and produce the test reports like this, which looks like this. If you got all the scenario passed, then the project the test reports will look like this. And it has it is a fairly readable, and it's in plain English. There are some links for this demonstration. If you wish to see the video demonstration of this presentation, how everything works, so you can see this video linked here. There's a source code on a GitHub. Then documentation, release documentation is online right there. Then yeah, that's it. Very few people. Anybody has any questions? Okay. If your application is developed in any other language, then you can use it for automating your acceptance tests or functional tests, because functional tests are totally independent of the application which they're using, which technology they're using, in which application developed. But this is basically for the web acceptance testing, so writing the automated tests like UT do for Selenium, so it doesn't matter which language they use for developing the application, basically. It's independent, yeah. So if your application is developing in C# or Java, then still you can write some functional tests or acceptance tests using Behat and automate that. Basically, advantage is like if you run your tests locally, then you can the test is running only on your local machine. So if you wish to show the screenshot or take the videos of or you're running tests, then you probably share with your customers and stuff. So it generates the videos and screenshot of all the tests, and you can. It is easy to. Run the cross-browser test, like if you are running in IE or if you wish to run in Safari, Opera, or different drivers, then you can. The Source Labs has a service that launch any browser of your choice. Then you can run your test in different browser. So, and it's easy. It's easier than maintaining the separate virtual machine for different browser and different platform, like if you run tests in Linux or in Windows or in a Mac, so
save the screenshot, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Any more questions? Okay. 5 minutes left. Thank you.